On this week's episode of the Rambler Sports Locker, women's soccer plays a nail-biter in the NCAA tournament, and RSL reporter Nolan Hawley is upset about the state of Chicago sports.
Also, the MVC Men's Soccer Championship goes to penalty kicks, and RSL reporter Connor Bergen is here to tell us about all the drama he saw on the field.
Welcome back to this week's episode of the Rambler Sports Locker. I'm Amanda Maurer.
And I'm Eric Moran. Over the weekend, the men's soccer team played in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament for a chance to win the conference championship, but also to win the NCAA tournament bid. On Friday, November 15th, the Ramblers kicked off MVC tournament play against the Bradley Braves in the semifinals at Loyola Soccer Park. The Braves scored first early in the contest, but the Ramblers quickly responded with a penalty kick goal from senior Aiden Magali. The Ramblers scored again in the second half when junior midfielder Justin Sukot found the back of the net in the 59th minute. The goal by Sukot would prove to be the difference as the Ramblers won 2-1. On Sunday, November 17th, the Ramblers took on the Missouri State Bears in the Missouri Valley Conference Championship. The Bears took an early lead in the second half. With the score 1-0 in favor of the Bears, junior midfielder Tyler Biggs scored a game-tying and season-saving goal in the 88th minute to force the game into overtime. After two scoreless overtime periods, the game went to penalty kicks. Sophomore midfielder Ethan Stoneman scored the game-winning goal of penalty kicks in the sixth round, resulting in the 5-4 shootout win. As a result of the win, the Ramblers now have 11 wins, 4 losses, and 4 ties on the season. This is the first time the Ramblers have ever won an MVC title since joining the conference in 2013. After the match, Magali was named the MVC tournament MVP, while Sukot, sophomore Billy Hensey, and freshman Andrew Mitchell were named to the all-tournament team. RSL reporter Connor Bergen was at the match on Championship Sunday, and he's in the studio today to tell us what he saw from the field. I am joined alongside RSL reporter Connor Bergen, who was at the men's MVC championship. So Connor, it took a last minute miraculous goal for Loyola to tie the game. What did you see on the field during that play?
Yeah, miraculous is right, Eric. In the second half, Loyola looked absolutely dead in the water. On offense, they weren't getting any legitimate chances on goal. And then on defense, Missouri State was being the aggressor. They were finding holes, the holes in Loyola's defense, looking like they might score one more goal to put the game away. Loyola players were getting frustrated with each other. Nothing was really working. And then with 1 minute left, the score 1-0. Loyola set up for a free kick for their last shot, basically, at tying that game. And Tyler Biggs picked the perfect time to come up with his first goal of the season, heading the ball into the back of the net to save the game. And from the field, I was absolutely stunned. From the way the game was going, I did not expect Loyola to score that goal, and I think a lot of fans in the crowd expected the same thing. But give them credit, they hung around and made the play to keep the game going.
So what was the atmosphere like at the championship game? Would you say that the Ramblers had home field advantage?
Yeah, so the game was played at Hoyne Field, Loyola's home field, and it definitely made a difference, and it showed in PKs and the penalty kicks. They let the Rambler fans actually go down to the sideline, so they were right up near the Missouri State players as they were kicking their shots, and two Missouri State players sent their penalty kicks way over the bar, and I would like to think that the Loyola fans making noise had something to do with that.
So if the Loyola fans were loud throughout the game, what was the scene like after the win?
Yeah, absolute pandemonium, like something out of a sports movie. It was one of the most joyous events or moments I had ever seen at a Loyola game. After Ethan Stoneman scored the winning penalty kick, he was immediately swarmed by teammates and fans. People started singing We Are the Champs by Queen. And then as they were lining up for their championship photos with the trophy, Loyola players started saying things like divine intervention while they were taking the photos. And from how that game went, it felt like something kind of divine was going on, because keep in mind, Missouri State was an absolute juggernaut. They were 17-0 on the season, ranked number 9 in the country. they were one of the top teams, not just in the MBC, but period. And for Loyola to hang around in that game and beat a Goliath like that in that fashion, it was remarkable.
So what's next for this team?
So next, the championship win has clinched the team a spot in the NCAA tournament. The Ramblers will face off against the Kentucky Wildcats in the first round, which is actually taking place tonight, Thursday, November 21st. So it's tournament game tonight.
So hopefully by the time this episode airs, the Ramblers will already be moving on to round two. So thanks, Connor.
Yeah, thank you.
Loyola's women's soccer team took on Hofstra University on Saturday, November 16th in the first round game of the NCAA tournament. Hofstra entered the game ranked 16th nationally. The two teams duked it out and remained scoreless the entire period. After heading to overtime, Hofstra player Sabrina Bryan scored the winning goal in the 94th minute of the game, ending the season for the Ramblers. This season, the Ramblers set a record for 8 straight wins and were Missouri Valley Conference tournament champions for the second year in a row. The team ended their season with a 14-5-1 record and was undefeated in conference play. Then on the hardwood, the Loyola men's basketball team hosted St. Joseph University on Saturday, November 16th. The Ramblers led 45-42 at halftime and pushed ahead in the second half to win by a final score of 85-68. Junior Cameron Krutwig was among 4 Loyola players to score in double digits. Krutwig matched a career high with 24 points. The Ramblers then hosted the Indiana University Purdue Jaguars on Wednesday, November 20th. Here is RSL reporter Amelia Ickes with a post-game analysis from the court.
The Loyola Ramblers just defeated the IUPUI Jaguars with many stars shining on the court tonight. I'm Amelia Ickes here at Gentile Arena here to tell you about it. The first half was close with IUPUI responding quickly to Loyola, but the Ramblers ended the half strong with a buzzer beater by freshman Marquise Kennedy. Junior Lucas Williamson led the team in scoring, putting 22 points on the board. Behind him was junior Cameron Krutwig, who brought in 18 points and 7 rebounds. Another star of the game was freshman Paxton Wojcik. Wojcik brought in 3 three-pointers, scoring 10 points overall. The Ramblers dominated as a whole in the second half with 24 points in the paint and 46 points scored total. The final score was 85-62, favoring Loyola. The Ramblers will next face off against South Florida at the Cayman Islands Classic on November 25th. For the Rambler Sports Locker, I'm Amelia Ickes. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Amelia. Following the win, the Ramblers will take on South Florida in the first round of the Cayman Islands Classic on Monday, November 25th.
On November 19th, the Ramblers took on the Chicago State Cougars at Chicago State's home arena. The Ramblers took the lead early and ran away with it, winning the game 98-53. 5 Ramblers scored double digits in the contest. Freshman guard Anna Brown and sophomore forward Allison Day both led the team in scoring with 16 points each, while junior guard Alexis Meyer led the team in rebounds with 10.
The Loyola women's volleyball team defeated Bradley 3-2 on Friday, November 15th in Gentile Arena. Senior outside hitter Quinn Speaker led the team with 16 kills and 16 digs. This win made it 20 for the Ramblers this season and earned them a bye in the first round of the Missouri Valley Conference tournament. The team then hosted Illinois State on Saturday, November 16th for the Ramblers senior night. The Ramblers lost the match 3-1, but freshman Addie Barnes still recorded a team high of 14 kills and 10 digs. The team will next head to Cedar Falls to take on University of Northern Iowa on Friday, November 22nd.
While the women's volleyball team is having a successful season, not many Chicago sports teams can say the same.
Here to offer some strong words to those struggling Chicago teams is RSL reporter Nolan Hawley in this week's Rambler Rant.
This past weekend, Matt Nagy made the choice to pull Mitch Trubisky in the third quarter of their game against the Los Angeles Rams, even though they were only down by 10 points. Coach Nagy was immediately criticized for this decision, with some people seeing it as throwing it on the towel for the season, but I think there's a larger theme at play here that deals with the state of all Chicago sports teams. Over the past few years, Chicago sports has taken an overall downturn, and it's really starting to get to me. Look, I get that I really don't have a dog in this fight. I'm a California kid who loves all things West Coast, but this is the city that I've fallen in love with. And only a few years ago, Chicago sports was happening. The Bulls had Chicago legends Jimmy Butler and Derrick Rose on the roster, the Blackhawks were the powerhouse of the NHL, and the Cubs were World Series champs. It made me so excited when I showed up my freshman year. But all I've been greeted to since coming to Chicago is mediocrity at best. The Bulls are a dumpster fire. The Blackhawks haven't made the playoffs in 2 years. The White Sox haven't been relevant since 2005. The Cubs just hired 40-year-old class clown David Ross. And the only thing going for the Bears is Brian Urlacher's hairline. The city of Chicago is in need of a revival. Its sports teams need to make a choice. Do they want to stay an average sports town or bring back the electric atmosphere of only a few years ago? We need tanks. We need units. We just need some guys being dudes. Chicago general managers, go out in a free agency. Throw all the money you've got. Go over the salary cap. Whatever you have to do, do it. And maybe even overdo it. Because desperate times call for desperate measures. That's all for me. Back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Nolan. Hopefully Chicago sports, and especially the Bears, can up their game this season.
Yeah, I'm really hoping the Bears turn things around, especially with Trubisky. For our full episodes and the chance to get in on the conversation, follow and like our social media handles for an up-to-date look at all things Rambler Sports.
Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Amanda Maurer.
And I'm Eric Moran. Check back next week for another episode of the Rambler Sports Locker.
And as always, don't forget to turn out the lights.